children, we have started our chapter work and energy. Okay, in the last class we discussed about work, what is work and the unit of work. What is the unit of work? It is joule. What is the equation for work? That is, work is equal to force into displacement. W is equal to F into S. W is equal to F into S. W work, F force, S displacement. What are the conditions for the, in order to do a work? That is force and displacement. Okay. What are the types of work? That is positive work, negative work and zero work. Which is the example for zero work? Pushing the wall. Pushing the wall is a zero work, isn't it? So hope you studied it well. Then we are doing some problems related to this equation. That is W equal to force into displacement. Work is equal to force into displacement. The next question is in your textbook, page number 148. That is example number 11.2. That is, a porter lifts a luggage of 15 kilograms from the ground. Here, a porter lifts a luggage of 15 kilograms. So, the luggage has a mass of 15 kilograms. M is equal to 15 kilograms. Okay. And then it is said that, and he puts it on his head 1.5 meter above the ground. He puts on his head 1.5 meter is above from the ground. So here the distance S is equal to 1.5 meter. Okay. Then calculate the work done by him on the luggage. A porter lifts a luggage of 15 kilograms from the ground. From the ground, he is lifting a luggage. That luggage has 15 kilograms and he put on in his head. And he put the luggage on his head, and the head and the ground, the distance between head and ground is 1.5 meter. Okay, then what is the work done? We have to calculate the work done here. Okay. How can we calculate the work done? We have the equation for work done. W work done, W is equal to F into S. That is force into displacement. Here displacement is given, that is 1.5 meter. Isn't it? But there is no force. How can we find the force? Here there is a clue, that is, in order to find the force, here there is a clue, that is mass is given. Okay, mass is given. So, we know the equation for force is equal to F is equal to M into A. Here you know, this is the distance between the head and the ground. So, here acts the force of gravity, isn't it? So, he lifting the luggage from the ground. So, he applying the force of gravity. So, here the acceleration will be acceleration due to gravity, that is G value. We studied it in the previous chapter, gravitation, the acceleration due to gravity. So here F is equal to M into G. Okay. Then we know the value of G. What is the value of G? In the previous chapter, we studied that. What is the value of G on Earth? Yes, it is 9.8 meter per second square. Here we take the approximate value, that is 15 into 10. That is the approximate value of 9.8 is 10. So here, in order to do the calculation more easily, we are taking the value of G is 10. Some cases in the question itself, it gives the value of G is equal to 9.8 meter per second square. At that time, you take the value of G as 9.8 meter per second square. Okay. So here 15 into 10 is 150. 150 is force, so 150 newton. Okay, then here work is equal to F is equal to 150 newton into S is equal to 1.5 meter. Okay, then it is 150 into 1.5, it is 225. What is the unit of work then? It is joule. Okay, it is 225 joule. Hope you understand this. Then we are doing the next problem, that is 250 joules of work is done when a force of 50 newton. When a force of 50 newton is applied on an object. Here, work done. 250 joules of work is done. How much force is applied when a force of 50 newton is applied on the object? So, here the work done will be W is equal to 250 joule. Okay. Then when a force of 50 newton is applied on an object, that is the force will be 50 newton. The force applied on the object is 50 newton. Then calculate the distance. Here we have to calculate the distance through which the object moves and also states its direction. Okay. And we have to calculate the distance of the object, that is S. And we have to state how is the direction, whether it is positive work, whether the applied force is in the direction of the displacement or opposite in the direction of displacement. Okay. So we have calculate S. We have the equation work. We have the equation of work, that is W is equal to F into S. So here W is given, that is 250 joule, and F is given, that is 50 newton into, we have to calculate S. So in order to calculate S, S is equal to, here 50 comes to this side, that is 250. Multiplication become division, that is 250 by 50. 0, 0 get cancelled. 5 into 5, it is 25. So it is 5 meter. Here we get a positive value here for the distance. It is given a positive value. So it is, this displacement is in the direction of applied force. Okay. Hope you understand this. Then we move on to the next question. The next question is, a magnetic crane lifts a mass of 1500 kilogram. Lift a mass of 1500 kilogram. So mass m is equal to 1500 kilogram. Okay. Then through a vertical height of 40 meters. So here height h is equal to 40 meter, that is when a magnetic crane lifts a mass, a crane is lifting a mass of 1500 kilogram, and it is in the height of 40 meter. Okay, the height means the distance. Here the height means the distance. So it is H is equal to 40 meter. Here height is the distance. Then calculate the work done in operating the crane. Here we have to calculate the work done in operating the crane. That is W is equal to. And it is given in the question that we have to take the value of G as 9.8 meter per second square. Here G, we have to take the G as 9.8 meter per second square. Okay. So here the equation is W is equal to F into S. We know F is equal to, what is F? In the previous question, we said that F is equal to ma. Here, it is acceleration due to gravity. That is, F is equal to m. F is equal to m into g. In the place of F, I am substituting this value. That is, F is equal to m into g into s. Okay. Here, m is equal to 1500 kilogram into g. In the question, it is given that we have to take the value of g as 9.8 meter per second square. So, it is 9.8 into the distance. Here it is height. That is 40 meter. So, it is 40. By calculating, we will get it as 588,000. What is the unit of work? It is joule. So, the work done will be 588,000 joule. Okay. I hope you get it because it is very simple. We are just substituting to this equation. In these questions, we are just substituting the values in the equation. Work is equal to force into displacement. Okay. W is equal to F into S. Then we are doing the next problem. It is very important. It is different from the previous problems. Okay. So, let's look at it. That is, certain force acting on a 20 kilogram mass. Here, a force is acting on 20 kilogram mass. So, here mass M is equal to 20 kilogram. Mass M is equal to 20 kilogram. Then, certain force acting on a 20 kilogram mass changes velocity from 5 meter per second to 2 meter per second. Here the velocity changes from 5 meter per second to 2 meter per second. At first the velocity is 5 meter per second and at last the velocity is 2 meter per second. Okay. We already discussed in motion the velocity, the initial velocity and final velocity. So, which one is the initial velocity here? Here, the body is moving 5 meter per second to 2 meter per second. So, the first velocity is, that is u. The initial velocity u is equal to 5 meter per second. Then at last, at the end of motion, the velocity is 2 meter per second. That is, the final velocity v is equal to 2 meter per second. So, we can take it as u equal to 5 meter per second and v equal to 2 meter per second. And here also we have to calculate the work done by the force. That is, certain force acting on a 20 kilogram mass changes its velocity from 5 meter per second to 2 meter per second. 5 meter per second to 2 meter per second. Calculate the work done by the force. How can we calculate the work done by force? Here we have the equation W is equal to F into S. Here we don't know the Here we can calculate the force from here. That is, we know F is equal to M into A. So, we can write it as M into A into S. But we don't know what is the value of S. It is not given. But here it is given some clues. That is, U equal to 5 meter per second and V equal to 2 meter per second. Here, we are moving to back, that is, to the chapter motion. There we studied three equations of motion and which is the third equation, that is, v square is equal to u square plus 2as. From there we get the value of S, that is V square is equal to U square plus 2AS. Isn't it? From this we can calculate the value of S. That is, then coming to this side, U square, that is V square minus U square is equal to 2AS. Then S is equal to, then S is equal to V square minus U square. Here 2A into S, that is 2A coming to this side, it will become division. Okay, here V square, the third equation of motion is V square is equal to U square plus 2AS. Here U square coming to this side plus, coming to this side minus, that is V square minus U square is equal to 2AS. Then S is equal to V square minus U square by 2A. Then we are substituting in the place of S. In the place of S, we are substituting this value, that is V square minus U square plus 2AS. In the place of S, we are substituting this value, that is W is equal to M into A into V square minus U square. Here we have to put the bracket, all divided by 2A. Okay, here A is in the numerator and A is in the denominator, so it get cancelled. A and A get cancelled. Then we get M into V square minus U square by 2. Then what is M here? It is 20 into, what is V here? It is 2 square minus equal to 2 square. Then U is equal to 5. So U is equal to 5 square all divided by 2. Okay, here 20 and 2 is cancelled, that is 10. Then we can write it as 10 into 2 square. What is 2 square? It is 4 minus 5 square. What is 5 square? 25. Here 10 into, what is 4 minus 25? It is minus 21. So the answer will be minus 210. Okay, hope you understand this. First we are starting from here. Here it is given the mass m is equal to 20 kilogram. Initial velocity u is equal to 5 meter per second. And final velocity v equal to 2 meter per second. Here it is not given the displacement. Here it is not given the acceleration. Then there our equation is work is equal to force into displacement. And we are writing this force as F is equal to M into A, that is mass into acceleration into distance. Okay, here it is not given the distance and the value of acceleration. So we are substituting the for the S. We are going back to our chapter motion. The third equation of motion, that is V square is equal to U square plus 2S. There we get S is equal to V square minus U square by 2A. By substituting in the place of S, we are substituting V square minus U square by 2A. That is, we will get here A and A get cancelled. Then M into V square minus U square by 2. Then we are substituting the value as 20 into 2 square minus 5 square by 2. Here 2 and 20 is cancelled. 10, then 10 into 4 minus 25. 4 minus 25, it is minus 21. Then 10 into minus 21, it is minus 210. Here, the unit of work is joule. So, here the unit of work is joule. So, minus 210 joule is the work done. Okay. Minus 210 joule is the work done here. It is work done. We get the value of work done as negative value. So it is a negative work. Negative work means here the force and displacement is in opposite direction. Here the force and displacement is in opposite direction. So we get the negative value, that is negative work. Okay, hope you understand these questions. These questions are very important. The problems, you must attend to the problems. Okay, in when I checked your paper, many of them skipped the problem section. So hope you understand all these things. In the next class, we start the next section of this chapter, that is energy. Here, our chapter name is work and energy. Work is completed from now. Now, the work, the section work is completed. Then we are moving to the next section, that is the second section of this chapter, that is energy. Okay. We will start the next section in the next class. We will continue in the next class. Thank you.